Hi, welcome to your channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant. I'm your host, Mohar, and I'm back today with another very inspirational story for all of you. The inspiration person who I'm introducing to you today is Dukhari Bala Devi, and forgotten armed Indian revolutionary of Bengal. She was the first woman revolutionary and freedom fighter of India, convicted under the now infamous Arms Act. Dukhari Bala Devi was born in a middle class Brahmin family in 1887 in Jaupara village under Nalhati PS limits in Birbhum district in undivided Bengal under the British Empire. Her parents, Neelmoni Chattopadhyay and Kamala Devi Kamini Devi, got her married off at a very early age, as was the tradition in those days, to Fani Bhushan Chakraborty. Her life, like any middle class housewife, was filled with domestic work, and then when her child was born, looking after her children. Bengal in those days was a hotbed of subversive activities and revolutionary action against the British Empire. The British decided to take a divide and rule policy and announced the partition of Bengal on October 16, 1905. This was denounced by all Bengalis, and they said this was a step taken under the divide and rule policy of the British government. They took radical action, agitations took place, and large-scale rioting against the British Empire. The revolutionaries came into full action. Her brother-in-law, Ghatak Nibaran, was already into armed action against the British Empire. On 26th August 1940, members of the Jugantar fraction of the Bengali Revolutionary Organization, Anushilan Samiti, intercepted Mauser pistols and ammunition being sent by Messrs. Roda and Company in Calcutta, who were gun dealers, to the company godown. They made way with 7 Mausers and 2 boxes of cartridges and other ammunition. This was sensational and highlighted as the greatest daylight robbery by the media. Nibaran Ghatak and Bipin Bihari Ganguly were responsible for this. Nibaran Ghatak was Bala Devi's brother-in-law. Nibaran helped Bipin Bihari Ganguly go underground and hide as a servant at the Rajbari or the Sai Shole Palace. He hid underground with the name of Nanen Ganguly for over 2 years. During this time, Bala observed and was influenced by these revolutionary activities of her brother-in-law and Bipin Bihari Ganguly. She told them that she wanted to join them, but Nibaran was hesitant. She then put forth an argument that if you boys can die for the motherland, why not we mothers also contribute and die for our motherland? Nibaran and Ganguly agreed, as they had no other way, and soon Bala's house became a hotbed of revolutionary activities and guerrilla warfare being launched against the British Empire. She not only learned how to fire arms and ammunition, she became an expert marksman, and she also taught other rebels how to use these guns and ammunition. It was at this time that Nibaran and Ganguly brought forth the cache of arms and ammunition consisting of 2 boxes of cartridges and 7 Mauser pistols to Kamala's, to Bala Devi's house. Dugbari Bala Devi hid them in her home. When on 7 January 1917, the government recovered a letter hinting that she had a cache of arms and ammunition at her home, they decided to raid her residence. The British surrounded her home, but Dukhari Bala Devi remained calm and collected and further passed on these arms and ammunition to her neighbor Suradhuni Molani with the help of a servant. Unfortunately, a local police mohr spotted this and reported them both. Bala was kept at Nalhati police station and tortured badly, but she was brave and bore all the pain and did not disclose any of her co-revolutionary names and the locations of additional arms and ammunition. This gave the revolutionaries a time to get away. She was later convicted under the Special Tribunal Court under the Arms Act. The now infamous Arms Act, Dukhari Bala Devi became the first freedom fighter, woman freedom fighter and revolutionary to be convicted under this infamous act. She was sent to Presidency Jail and convicted by the Special Tribunal Court for 2 years and 6 months. On 8 March 2017, she went rigorous imprisonment and her duty was to continuously pound food weighing over 10 to 15 kgs in a day, every day, with the pounding stone. This sapped her energy, and added to this, she was further tortured every day, but she never disclosed the name of her co-revolutionaries and the position and place of other hidden arms and ammunition. She was later released. Upon her release, she took up philanthropic works and social work. She died unknown and forgotten by the government of India on April 28, 1970. Her motto was always, "If you boys can sacrifice your lives for your country, so can your women." Dukhari Bala Devi, the first female freedom fighter and revolutionary, armed revolutionary, convicted under the infamous Arms Act, a forgotten revolutionary and freedom fighter, forgotten by her country and her countrymen. My attempt today to highlight her story and remind her, our countrymen, of the responsibility we have towards these forgotten revolutionaries. Friends, I am sure you enjoy these inspirational stories which I bring out for you on your favorite channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant. A request, please do like the videos, subscribe the videos, press the bell icon and share these videos with your friends and family. I will be back with another very inspirational video on your favorite channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant. Till then, good luck, all the best, stay safe.